guys, so we've just finished off our assembly and we've also put together our presentation view. So it's got to that time where we start making our drawing. So coming down here and then going across to our ISO and go and create. One thing we can always check on this as well, so I like this this format. I know if you've been a long time watcher of these different videos, I used to do it very differently. But if you want to have a look here at sheet, it starts at A3, which isn't a too bad a size for a drawing anyway. The other one was like A1, which was huge, and things like that. The old files that I used to select. So now I'm really happy with this one. So we're gonna start off by doing the base. I'm sorry, the cover page, which is what we normally do. So let's spin this around. It's decided to start us off with the old exploded view. Let's go 10. That might be mammoth. No, it's not. 7. Alright, that'll work. And that looks pretty cool. Let's go OK. Ooh, do not like. We don't want invisible lines. It's a cover page. We're not going to go invisible lines on that bad boy. Alright, so we'll have that there. Let's go another one. We'll just go the assembly, open that up. Can we load it from straight on? Yes, we can. I'll have this tilted the other way. That'll be good. So this is at 10. We ended up getting 7 for the other one, didn't we? Cool. So we've got that. Won't have hidden lines on that either. Grab that. Whoops. And grab the edge. Whenever you want to move your drawings on this, you know, actually grab the edge. And let's add in our text. Literally, I'm not going to prescribe this to a year level because I don't think it really needs to be. and I'm literally just going to call it Bench Project. And leave that like that. Now, important part of this is we're going to change the eye properties now. If you've been keeping up with me, I had a brainwave last time I was doing this, so of just saving these and then deleting the things on them and then adding new things. So I'd have to keep filling in the eye properties every time. So. And that's actually been working out really, really well. Project Bench. One of the other things I like as well is that keeping everything super simple in the names does speed up this whole process as well. Now, the cost of this was, so if it was made out of pallets, it was free. The problem if we use all of the, so if we just use pine as well, it ended up being about $35, so $10 over the student limit for senior school projects. So every student at my school gets a $25 limit that we can spend on materials. At our school, it's the only way we can kind of function within a faculty budget. Now I'm going to go OK, that's all filled in. And let's go save. And I need to make a new folder, I'm going to call it drawings. And might make a new one within that, PDF. PDF's cool. And we're going to save it in. So we can save these in the drawings folder, and oh, I should not have done that. Okay, we might need to change that one anyway. Let's go in here, the drawings. Come on, computer, you can do this. Oh, I'm in the wrong one anyway. Which bench are we there? Cool. So within that, oh, did it actually go on there? It did go on PDFs. That's so annoying. What I'm going to have to do is exit that, open this back up. So I want that in the drawings folder. Whoops, sorry. So we've got it in the right place. I actually didn't want to call it that. I want to call it cover page. I'm not sure if that's one word or two words, but it doesn't actually matter really. Skip all. Okay. So we've got that there. Now I can quickly go file, export, PDF, and save this one in PDFs. Go save. Alright, now dodging the title block that we don't want to have to redo every time. Okay, let's delete these. Okay. And let's start adding some parts in. So, probably going to do it the same way we made the parts for it. We'll probably go the same way there. So, what do? We start off with the bottom, didn't we? Basic frame, open that up. Top, rotate. That'll do. I don't know why it's making everything so tiny. But I guess we can work with that. Three. Alright, that's better size. So as per usual as well, I'd like to have a couple of these. And we'll also go like that. Go okay. Move this one up a little bit. Double click on the outside edge, add some color, okay. And then we can start doing, I'll add another one in first, probably. I'm just going to keep doing that. Anyway, we wanted our leg, didn't we? Open that up, go to the top, rotate that bad boy around. Then we ended up going with four. Move this one over here, add some color. Okay, we've definitely got room to put one more in here down here. We could, so we've done that. Oh, we'll do the C rail that way, it's kind of all part of the same frame and it will look good. Line that up, come down here. Click on that, add a color, let's move it around as well over to here. Let's move that down a little bit. Okay, so this is a super easy one simply because it doesn't have any of our angles that we need to try to get. Like usual as well, we're going to start with our overall length and width. Trying to keep some of these measurements over this side as well. Simply because you don't have as much room to maneuver. So you'll notice that. Oh, you're gonna. Okay, there we go. Whenever I'm trying to do this, I'll keep the overall, say, width over this side. Also trying to make sure we line them up down there. Oh, top's not very well done, but that'll be okay. Let's get some overall lengths. Okay. And final one. Okay. So now I'm gonna finish off by, let's do some of this. Measurement, and we need to know that measurement. Keep them lined up. Fantastic. We can also do that measurement there. All right. Not happy with that at all. Let's delete that one. Really don't like having our measurements overlapping. 12, so that was overlapping, which I'm not happy with, and we'll do it down the bottom, like that. We know that's 19, we know that's 315 from there. We know that distance across, we know the width, we know the space from the edge there. Oh, that's the bottom too, so that's perfect. So we know that it's 5mm either side, so that's perfect. Alright, cool. So that one's done. Let's quickly go back up here. Get our width of this. Well, the reality is, well, if you're looking at the front cover, you know these join together. What am I doing? I have stuffed up. I should go to here. Is it there or is it view? We'll make sure we have the appropriate units. See here, it's got a comma with the zeros there. I'm not happy with that. Okay, so I've quickly gone through and just changed that around. So. Just wanted to show you that I need to go through the annoying process of deleting the dimensions that I already made and redoing them appropriately. And I can understand too, like, why people would get confused if you're trying to put these together with a comma there and they're thinking, oh, is that 5,000 millimeters or whatever. Also, just remembering, guys, the side that you click on originally is the side that you see the text appears on, so trying to make sure you're doing that the correct way, so that way it all fits together. So we'll click this side and then that side. See there, it fits perfectly, just like that. We can go down here as well. That one. Okay, and then finally, I'm not sure if this will like it too much. Clicked on the wrong side. Alright, move on to our next one. Remembering overall sides first. And then moving on after that. So let's go down there first. The hotkey for this D. Cool. Okay, so now what we should do, so making the assumption that people know a bit of math, we can go like that. So then you know that it's going to be evenly spaced 5mm either side. Let's though then afterwards make sure we give people the information there. And then let's go from there to there, 315. Okay, and let's go from that edge to that edge. Just like that. All right, fantastic. Let's do the overall sizes again for this one. And let's go, actually we can get the top width. I'll use that more of the page. And then down here as well. Okay, so now let's start figuring out some of these holes. So you can see it's a little bit hard to see, so we've got that one, and then we've got our hole there, so I might also grab that. Is that not going to work? Dimension. Need to zoom in. Annoyingly. Okay. One thing you need to do when you're doing holes, though, as well, is make sure we include our center lines into these, just like that. We can also include our center lines if we wanted to down here, but I don't normally do both. Not saying that's correct or incorrect. Okay, so now let's start laying these out. So using a dimension tool, how far apart are they? They're 30 25. Clicked on the wrong one first though. Okay. Let's go from there to there. 17.5. Okay. And then we can. Might even just do it over here. How far apart are they? One there. She would have helped me more when we're actually drawing this if I did dimension it from there to that one or that one. Have that 108 come up. Then I wouldn't have to figure that out. But anyway, that's all fine. I think they're all the dimensions you actually need to do that. Sort of, kind of, not really. So let's quickly dimension over here. Make sure people know. Just like that. Cool. So now we're quickly going to do some of our text so that people know what these are. So we'll call that C rail. And then we have a 10. Cool. Cool. Like I like to do as well, make sure we go 1, 2. Okay. And let's add our text in for our leg as well. Continue. Leg. 1, 2. Highlight. 10. Okay. And then we've got our base. Times 2, highlight, make that 10, and go OK. Alright, so you can see here this is still saved as cover page, so I'm going to file, save as, I'm going to save this as frames. I think, yeah, that's the whole frame, so that should be fine. I'm going to save that like that. And then we're going to go to File, Export, PDF. Still came in as frames. Keep that name consistent. All right, now we can go through and delete all this. Okay. Cool. All right, and we're going to move on to our next part now, which is going to be our slats and our backrest. And hopefully our dowel will fit as well. Oh, sorry, we need to do our armrest. It wasn't actually the whole frame before, so I might just do. So we're at top left temp 2 from when I stuffed up. Alright, so I'm going to rotate this all the way around so we can have that like that. I think we need to change that to 4 in the end. Yep. That way, and then we have an angled version like that. Okay, move that all the way over, double click, make it colored. Okay, cool, so we got them there. Remember, we need the different ones, so we're only making one of that because we needed that was at top left. We'll go at top right and we'll open that and we'll rotate that around. It's good too because you can kind of see directly straight away from this that they're different because one's up and one's down. Keep that there, line him up, have that there. Whoa, we don't want to do that. Oh, now I have to do that whole thing again. Doesn't take too long, I guess we've got to get it right. 4. Okay, so we've made that a bit bigger. Make it one down here, make that there and go okay. Move this around over to here. Make sure we're not going over our border there, double clicking. And making that the appropriate color. Move that down a little bit. We are going to need a little bit of room to make sure we add all the appropriate dimensions in. Let's add our backrest in now. Open that up. So over there, top, rotate it around. Okay. I mean, unfortunately, we're not going to be able to fit everything on this one, I don't think. But we're pretty close. Can we see the angle on that very well? Yes, we can. Cool. All right. And we're going to make sure we really point it out anyway. So Let's start doing dimensioning. Another beauty of what we're doing here as well is the fact that is the fact that like when you split them up like this and you're just deleting the ones off top, you're keeping all your pre-made settings from your last file as well, which is nice. So I don't have to go back through and make sure that I've got this set to the decimal point instead of the comma and stuff like that. So I think that's a massive positive. So let's start off with our overall lengths. And our overall width. And thickness. Okay, so we're gonna have to do that for both top. Okay, and thickness. And let's do the next one as well. Like that, we've got nice round numbers here, nothing too confusing. And our width. Okay. How well is that going to appear? 95, 85. Have to move that down the other end now, and I. Keep that like that, so that makes that easier. All right, and then we'll do the different widths down there, down from here, and that'll be better. All right, but we might start off with this top one first, because it's actually quite difficult to do. So what we're gonna wanna do is the dimension tool, top, bottom, snap there, okay. So that helps us know the width there. Now we're gonna quickly go that edge. Not snapping, don't know why, not very helpful. And then making sure we know that it's at 85. Then nothing's crossing over, which is really good. And then if I go hard line, why is that coming up weird? Is that another one? No, it should be coming up 19. but for some reason it's not, so let's go over here. I guess the reason is it wasn't on that angle. So we can leave that like that. So we know that. The only thing we don't know is the width of that is 9. Alright, so we'll leave it like that. And then we'll have to try to repeat those different things on this one. Let's go down this edge. Can kind of see, yeah, so it's a lot of the more the angles on that part on here. We do get our straight lines on here though as well, which is, whoa, I pushed in the middle by accident. That was that. I think we did our width, yeah, we've already done our width down there, so we don't need to do it down this end, because we're doing some other things, making sure these are correct. Is that gonna... stuff that up, dimension. That one, and that one, that's better. For some reason, when you select the middle points, it won't follow the actual angle, but when you select the actual pieces there, it does follow. I mean, that makes it, now that I've said that, it does make a bit of sense why that does that. Okay, and I think I'm good. All right, now the last one here is the confusing bit here. That's a different size to the rest of it. Go here, 42, okay, and that's 40. So you know how that breaks down. Bottom of it should be 48, and that should actually be fine. But I did tons of measurements on that, because I mean, we saw from when we were putting together the actual part that it wasn't too confusing. So we can go here like that, and we can go back, support. down there and go okay. Look at that, fits perfect. Calculated that, not really. Okay, so we're gonna go armrest. Right. Sorry, bit of thinking there. Had to think about which one we pulled where. Armrest right. Cool. Now, one thing's like, I mean, ergonomically, it makes a lot of sense, and it's really good that we did the angles. As you can see, like, it does take a lot more effort because you are essentially adding more work, because you can't just copy pieces over. Unless, yeah, if you're putting angles, because it's going to obviously be a bit different. Unless it's a straight angle like on the backrest, which is always nice. Save that. Cool. Alright. So we can delete that one now. And the final bits we need to do are the boring ones and the dowels. When I say boring ones, though, it's a positive, because they're also the easiest ones to do, aren't they? So we might go back slat, open that up, which is literally just a rectangular prism. We got that there. 4. That there. Oh, that one is a lot longer, isn't it? It might be 6. Whoa, 6, not 65. Might be that like that. So we can still add in air. Isometric view over here. Make sure we add some color to it. Drag these down. Alright. Now let's add in our seat slat. Back slat. Backrest. Seat slat. Open that up. Rotate that around. That's 6 for the top. This is going to be pretty close, yeah. Okay, let's move that around. Separate these up a little bit, move them down. Cool. Last thing we need to add in is our dowel. Specifically a 38mm dowel. Alright, we'll have that like that, and like that, and like that. I do enjoy putting this like this dowel in here and stuff, because it's by far the smallest piece of this entire thing, but it's appearing the same size. It's a really good way to give kids some perspective on actually what they're drawing. So, like, while it looks bigger, and while it's mostly to show that it's dimensions and it's features and stuff, it really helps kids out to be like, oh, but it, I mean, in reality, I need to make sure I'm reading these dimensions and making sure it's the right, the correct size. So. I do always think that's a really good thing. Alright, so we've done those. We can do, where are we? Center lines. Okay, let's get some more dimensions, D for dimension. Alright, well, I've made a mistake there, because I really want to be able to select, yeah, there we go. I don't know if you guys saw how much harder it was to select that when I added the center line. Apparently 30.25 is the size from there. I wonder if... Yeah, see, that's wrong. I've clicked on something. Oh, sorry. It's the edge. I'm being silly. That is correct. But it doesn't read very well, so we're going to go dimension, and we're going to go from there to there. Make sure people know that it's 35. And we'll do the distance apart. It's 35 as well. And I should know. It's from the edge there. Okay, so we'll do that as well. as dimensioned up as I want it to be. This one's easy, we just need length, width, and thickness. Okay. Now, quickly, do some of we've got a back slat, continue, back slat, times how many do we need? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6, make that 10, and let's go seat slat. And finally, add dowel, which we need. Can't just write a lot. Two for each of the seats on the bottom, and there's five of those. So that's going to be 20. No, 10 for each end. Let's make that 10. That fit? Doesn't fit. Dang it. Okay, I think. Cancel. I think I can move this up. Can I? Yes, I can. Just move it around a little bit like that. Alright, cool. That looks good. Let's get a file. Save as. Splat and down. Save that like that, file, export, PDF, PDFs, save, alright, fantastic. So you can see there we've done that, 32 minutes, so this is a long video unfortunately. Gonna open this back up, I think it's a testament as well to, I haven't actually been on Inventor for a little bit. Let's right click on that, we're gonna produce our booklet again, so we're gonna combine our files. Whoops, we're on the wrong size, let's bring that over here, so we're gonna combine our files. Make sure we have them in the right order, just like that. And we can go combine. And we need to save. Make sure we save it in our, or that's in our school content, so that's the wrong spot. We can open that up though. Go back to here. Drawings, PDFs, bench. Project booklet and go save. So now we've got our booklet all together, just like that. Exit out of that. So hopefully now we've added those together. So we've gone through the parts, we've gone through assembly, presentation, and then finally the actual drawing of the project. So hopefully you found this really helpful. And we're gonna be moving on to new projects soon. But yeah, hopefully I'm going to have some kids give me some more ideas. I'm thinking about the impossible table that people might have seen being the next video. So look forward to that, and thank you for watching.